I feel like I was honestly living under a rock until this video because I had never heard of a Hatchimal until today. Maybe it's because I don't have a kid, but considering how popular they were when they came out in 2016, I really thought I would have at least heard about them. If you're like me and have no idea what the hell a Hatchimal is, it's basically a hybrid of a Tamagotchi and a Furby. Hatchimals are little robot animals that come inside plastic eggs when you get them and actually peck at the egg and hatch themselves. You have to teach it how to walk and talk and all that, and it has 5 stages of growth, eventually becoming a kid. Retailing for $59.99, these toys were so in demand you couldn't even find them in store. What is up, you guys? Hope you're having an awesome day. I'm your host, Eamon Hassan, and welcome back to another video. Now, before I get into it, make sure to check out our comedy channel, Top 10 Central, to add some extra lols into your day. I know you want to. But either way, today we are diving into kids' toys with the top 10 scary Hatchimal theories. Starting us off at number 10 is swearing. Now, Hatchimals can talk, they can sing, and you can teach them to talk more as they grow. But some reports from parents have claimed that their children's Hatchimals have mumbled things like me and other swear words while still snoozing inside the egg. Pre-hatch, the thing is already muttering expletives before it's even entered the world. That's how you know how done it is with the world. Hasn't even come out yet, is already saying me. Others claim that the robots snore quite loudly while they're incubating inside loudly with a hard E at the end of it, making it sound like the F word, but it isn't really. I mean, I feel like surely this should have been discussed during the prototype stages of the toy, not when it's already in the homes of thousands of people and kids. It doesn't take a rocket scientist to see why parents would be upset with a swearing animal in the hands of their children. Coming in at number 9 is the hatching. So not all of the Hatchimals are doing what they're supposed to be doing. To make the egg hatch, the child is just meant to rub it for a while, and within 30 to 40 minutes of having it, it should start hatching by pecking away at the egg. Many kids have been traumatized by their Hatchimals stopping their hatching midway and never continuing. Chad Meyer shared on Twitter that this traumatized his daughter since she had to then surgically extract the toy herself after it couldn't peck its way out. And it's not as easy to get the toy out of the egg as you'd assume. A lot of parents have ended up killing the Hatchimal while trying to get it out, while another man used a 1000 degree knife to try and hack it open and still struggled. Like, how do you struggle? What is this egg made out of? Titanium? Get out of here! God! At number 8 we have AI. Now, you'd think artificial intelligence would only be reserved for important work and technology, but apparently Hatchimals have AI inside of them too. The AI has multiple stages where at first it's an egg, wherein you must treat it like a real life egg. It then progresses to hatching, where it can start getting sick, scared, or happy, or a bunch of other emotions. The next stage is baby, then comes toddler, and finally kid. Now, apparently this process is long as hell and requires a lot of time and effort on the kids' part, and I don't think long-term commitment is something babies are into. I feel like grown men aren't into it either, but that's just me. Apply ice to that burn, honey. Either way, this theory suggests that this furthers AI's becoming sentient and one with humans, since it's encouraging us to treat this machine as a human with feelings and help it grow. Teaching kids that machines have feelings may be harmless for now, but it could very well make us one step closer to the Terminator. Now, I'm not saying these little Hatchimals could start thinking for themselves and push your kid down the stairs, but I'm also not saying that. Be wary of the Hatchimals. Filling item 7th slot is violence. So even though it's advertised as a kid's toy, and I mean it is a kid's toy, that isn't the only demographic buying the toy. Some sick-minded people have purchased the little furries only to cause them major harm. These serial killers in the making post videos of themselves stabbing the egg and animal with various instruments. One guy used a hunting knife to pry open the egg and then continued to use the knife by stabbing the Hatchimal, tearing it open so we could see its insides. All the while, a woman in the background kept shouting at him, telling him to stop hurting it. And yes, I'm aware it's a toy with no actual feelings, but come on, it's the principle of the thing. There's nothing sacred anymore. Now, at number 6 are the stillborns. You wouldn't think something that tragic could happen to a kid's toy, would you? Well, you learn something new every day. Customers have had their little babies hatched to then not talk or walk and just essentially be stillborn, which results in the children who have them crying their eyes out, thinking it's their fault. And the worst part about all of this was Spin Master, the company that produced them, was silent on the issue, not getting back to any customers. Eventually, they issued a statement saying, since the toys feature a high level of technology, they may not always perform as expected. That's all well and good, but what about my crying child over here, who's not gonna understand that? You know what I mean? Coming in at number 5 are the after effects. We need to talk about the lasting after effects a stillborn or defective Hatchimal could have on the kids that end up with them. In multiple videos online, I've seen 2 siblings both get the toy with one hatching and one not, and the kid with the broken one is genuinely sad and concerned with the little furry creature they had just gotten. But what is that experience gonna do to them when they're older? Is it gonna fuel their insecurity, like, why did my Hatchimal die on me as a kid? Was I not enough? Was I not good enough? Have you guys ever had your Tamagotchi that you've taken care of for at least 5 generations die while you sleep? Do you know how much that hurts? The guilt? I'm not saying it from personal experience. I am. And a Hatchimal is so much worse, you actually have to hold it and hear it suffer and watch it die in your hands. Like, major trauma alert. At number 4 is the black market. Hatchimals were so in demand when they came out, just compare them to toilet paper when people first started freaking out about COVID. There we go, now we understand the urgency here. Anyway, there was actually a black market for Hatchimals. Parents out there spent thousands of dollars on a toy that cost $60 retail price. Thousands of dollars, take that in, people. And parents aren't always the most tech savvy or like scam smart. So yes, a lot of them got scammed and were horrified to see their $2,000 was spent on a box with a shoe inside and not a Hatchimal. RIP to their bank accounts. I'm sorry, no matter how much I love my children, I'm not gonna buy any of them a $3,000 egg. That may be defective. I'll just give them a regular egg. Go nuts. Filling our number 3 slot are the life lessons. According to Naomi Riley at the New York Post, Hatchimals are teaching children all the wrong lessons about how to relate to other human beings. Well, no, Riley, that's because it's a toy, not a human being. You'd think with how they have to teach the Hatchimal how to talk and walk, the kids would be learning something, but turns out the more a toy does for a child, the less they end up doing for themselves. Back when Furbies were all the craze, a study done on kids who had them showed that they seem deeply anxious yet attached to their robotic companions, and claimed dolls that don't talk are a lot of hard work because you have to use your imagination. I mean, isn't that the point, kids? You have to make the backstory up. That's what I did with my Bratz dolls. Chloe, Jade, and Sasha were definitely not telling me their thoughts, but I mean, it would have been pretty damn cool if they were. I just knew fashion from day one. I knew they would have loved their outfits. I knew that. Chloe, Jade, Sasha, Yasmin, they would have told me I'm a fashionista. And the 5th Bratz doll. Anywho, those are my childhood dreams. Out the window. Either way, playing is actually a child's job. It helps them physically, socially, and intellectually. So with all these kids taking the easy way out, they're hindering their growth. Sociable robots pave the way for a more narcissistic playing experience. The kids think they're engaging socially, but they are not. It only counts if it's with another person. So not only do Hatchimals hinder a kid's social skills, it hinders their imagination as well. Ain't nobody got time for that. I'm not even gonna give my kids a cell phone. I'll just give them a rock and be like the old times. No, I'm kidding, that'd be cruel. I'm not gonna do that. Now, at number 2 is possessed Hatchimal. So this was shared by an anonymous Redditor who claims they got their little sister a Hatchimal for her birthday since she really, really wanted one. And the one thing I haven't mentioned yet is that the Hatchimal's eyes change color and flash. So while the Hatchimal is in the egg, its eyes flash, which some think is cute, I think is a tad creepy, but that's just me. But each color is associated with an emotion. For example, green is sick, pink is needy, blue is cold, purple is hungry, and so forth. The Redditor said that while his little sister was asleep the night after she got it, she kept it on her bedside table so she could monitor it. Midway through the night, the Hatchimal started making weird deep sounds and its eyes kept flashing from red, meaning upset, to purple. It started making weird deep sounds as well, and as I already mentioned before, they make little cute sounds as they sleep or they pick up or they hear if said enough times. So who the hell or what the hell was making those deep sounds next to the Hatchimal to make it malfunction between upset and hungry? We don't know. And finally, at number 1 is get rich quick. Reading about this one personally hurt me because A, it's true, and B, it's just not a good move. So back in 2016, New York Times bestselling author Sarah Gruen saw how Hatchimals were getting super popular and planned a quick, in her eyes, foolproof get rich quick scheme. She was already in $150,000 of debt since she was trying to fund legal fees and production for a docuseries. So Sarah decided to buy a bunch of Hatchimals and sell them for a profit. 156 Hatchimals later, she thought she was set, but here's where hits the fan. As she was listing the items on eBay, after the 3rd one, she got an item limitation message, meaning she could only list 3 Hatchimals for sale a week. Absolutely ruined, people, absolutely ruined. And even more in debt, she started selling them on her Shopify account, since that's the only platform that let her list her entire stock. I mean, these Hatchimals essentially ruined her life, but I mean, on the flip side, it wasn't the best plan. Sarah, you should have asked your investment advisor. Not a good plan. And that is it for today's video, guys. Hatchimals. Who would have thought they would be this interesting? I certainly didn't. Let me know what you guys thought in the comments below. As always, I'm your host, Eamon Hassan, and I'll catch you in the next one. Bye! The thing is already muttering expletives. The thing is already muttering expletives before it's even entered the world. That's how you know how much. Oh, I thought that was me. Okay, let me try this again. Okay, pre-hatch. The thing is already. How do you say it again?
Expletive.
So physically, socially, and intellectually. So back in 2016, New York Times bestselling author Sarah Gruen saw how Hatchimals were getting super popular and planned a quick. Sarah Gruen? Is it Sarah or Sarah?
Oh, Sarah.
Okay.